Today, guys, on Beer Geek Nation, we are doing something a little special. As you can probably see, we are doing a compare and contrast between a barrel-aged version of a beer and a non-barrel-aged version of beer. This has been a video long time in the coming, and I have to give a huge, huge, huge thanks to Jeff for hooking me up with both of these beers, or I would not be able to do this. And guys, we are talking about a brewery of Massachusetts, Jack's Abbey. They're doing all craft lagers. I've had a bunch of their beers. Each one is better than the next. They do some fantastic Imperial Pale lagers. Their Hop Ponyish Union, you can check out my review for it. It's amazing. They do double IPLs. But the beers in question tonight are their Imperial Baltic Porters, or just Baltic Porters, I suppose. This is their Framinghammer, coming in at 10% alcohol by volume. It's a Baltic Porter brewed with oats and brown sugar. And we are also talking about the barrel-aged version, which they use Kentucky bourbon barrels to age it in. I couldn't find a time about how long they actually age it, but this is the newest batch of it. Both of these beers are listed as 10%, but I would assume the bourbon barrel age is probably a point or two higher just based on the actual aging process. What is a Baltic Porter? It's based in this exact, you know, video, and a Baltic Porter is basically an Imperial Stout, in this case, aged with a lager yeast. In typical cases, Baltic Porters can range anywhere up to about, you know, between like 5% and 8%. And it's basically a stout that they brew, or excuse me, that they ferment with a lager yeast. In this case, they got it up to 10%. I'm assuming probably with that brown sugar. Long conditioning time. It's a hard style to make, especially at this alcohol level. So I really want to get into these. I've had the non-barrel aged, but I have not had the barrel aged version yet. So again, Jeff, thank you so much for doing this. So let's get into the non-barrel aged version. Again, 10%. Oh my gosh. Huge roasted character, chocolate, coffee. Oh wow. That's amazing. Silky, silky, silky smooth. Just a velvet coat of coffee and chocolate. Coat your tongue. Some sweetness to it. Definitely some sweetness in there. Definitely kind of a roasted coffee bean type of flavor. So, so clean. No lingering flavors at all in the aftertaste. A little bit of chocolate, a little bit of an espresso characteristic, but 10%. I would be hard pressed to find that in this one. Wow. And again, that's through that long conditioning process. You know, it gets them, they don't ferment warm at all, so that alcohol just kind of gets subdued. It's that lager yeast. It just wants that cold temperature. It just works for these big beers because it just keeps the alcohol in control. All right, so let's try the barrel-aged version. Holy cow. Wow, immediately you're getting those big vanilla, tobacco, oaky notes. A little bit of coconut in there. That's ridiculous. Wow. 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 Yeah. So, you know, you get big chocolate and coffee in this one. This has that, but it's very subtle and it's very just incorporated together. And on top of that, you get vanilla, you get coconut, you get oakiness, you get a sweet kind of pipe tobacco. There might be a little bit of heat in this one, only when compared to this one, because I'm not getting any alcohol in this at all. I get a little bit in this one. Wow. You get almost like a chocolate, like a bourbon-soaked chocolate cherry in this one. Lots of vanilla. Yeah. The roast character is very, very present in this one. The roast character is almost completely gone through the aging in this one, replaced more by that vanilla, that oakiness, that subtle, again, a kind of coconut, toasted coconut sweetness. Both are amazing beers. Let me just put that out there. If you haven't heard of Jack's Abbey, trade for them. Do what you have to do. If you're in the New England area, definitely check these guys out. They are just brewing some fantastic, fantastic beers. This is probably one of my favorite barrel-aged beers I've ever had. It's so subtle, yet complex. It's one of those beers, I've had it, I haven't had it, but I've been sipping on it a little bit in here, and it just keeps changing. I get coconut, I get vanilla, pipe tobacco. With this one, it's one of, it's the, easily the best Baltic Porter I've ever had, but it stands up to some of the best Imperial Stouts you'll ever have. Just chocolate, espresso, and to see kind of the metamorphosis that it goes through in a barrel, is just amazing. It goes a million miles to see what the brewers are doing with these types of beers and lagers in general. It's just awesome stuff. So my hat off to Jack's Abbey. And again, a big thank you to Jeff for hooking me up with these beers, basically, to try. And he wanted me to do this. It's awesome, awesome stuff. Look, I'm telling you, look out for these guys. These guys are going to be big, big, big in the next couple years. And this beer, this barrel-aged version, is not on too many people's radar outside of Massachusetts right now. And I got a feeling in a couple years, good luck getting this one. It's going to be huge. So with that said, folks, remember, life's too short. Drink amazing beers. Cheers.